Hello and welcome to this Hot Indonesia Love and Family Special. I'm Dalton Taranaka in Jakarta. With co-hosts Millie Lukito and Linda Ibrahim, topics that focused on the close ties that bind relatives and partners were popular ones. And we begin with an issue that's under government review. Love and faith. Should mixed religion marriages be allowed? A 1974 law says that marriage is only legal if done according to the religious beliefs of the two people. Islam forbids marriage with a non-Muslim, so for the most part here, mixed marriages are banned. But the Constitutional Court announced that it is reviewing the case of a Catholic man who wants to marry his Muslim partner. The plaintiff says the ban results in him losing his liberty. Now, this issue is not a new one. It's been around for a while. Another case of religion versus individual choice. Linda, as a Muslim, are you okay with the ban, or is a change needed?
I personally feel that religion is something private. You know, it shouldn't be included in a lot of the state laws. It should be what the people choose to do. You know, so yes, religious tenets may say one thing, but if they want to do something else, it's up to their own free will. And the state should not be in the way of them doing that. But it's hard in Indonesia. We actually even have a Ministry of Religion to take care of this. And I feel when you mix state power and religious tenets, and bear in mind that Indonesia acknowledges 6 official religions, and it's very messy. Whereas if you let it to the people free will, yes, there is a concept of sin and all that, but that's a personal responsibility and obligation. Let people choose, let people do, and you know, bear the responsibility. I think that would be better. That's the way I see it. So for me personally, okay. I have a lot of friends who are in mixed religious marriages, and to me, that's fine. That's their choices. You know, it doesn't affect me, but it makes me sad that I know that it has affected a lot of their decisions, a lot of their livelihoods, and it will affect their children later. For example,
not just marriage, but many other issues. Let me get to Millie. As we know, people usually find ways to get around the law here in all sectors, whether religious or public laws. Now, in mixed couples, many people go overseas and get married and then return here to live. Millie, where are you on this issue?
I'm with Linda. You know, I think people should be given the choice and independence to marry whoever they love. But in Indonesia, when you marry someone, you actually marry the whole family. You know, unlike those in the United States. So if this is a mixed marriage, the culture will be different between two families. And therefore, the tension and the difficulties and the challenges will be more than if you marry in the same religion. So
hey, but there are divorces in people who are the same religion. I mean, you know, there are problems everywhere.
Yes, that's correct. But the elders, the statesmen, perhaps they think that even those in the same religion marriages sometimes end up in divorce. How about, you know, the mixed marriage? It will pose even more challenges. So this is probably why the state intervenes in the people's day-to-day decision.
Do you really think, Billy, that they're really considering the results of a happy marriage? I think they're just following the teachings of Islam, because most of the leaders are Muslim, and they're just right.
The teaching of Islam in Christianity is the same. It is more encouraged for you to find a spouse, a partner, life partner.
Okay, but that's the key word, encouraged. Encouraged. That's in Islam, it's bad. Okay, now the religious teachings of any faith, you know, are what they are, and I guess it comes down to, as Linda mentioned earlier, and I want to ask you more pointedly, Linda, that should government be sanctioning the beliefs of any faith? I mean, we are supposed to be a secular state, and this issue runs into many different issues, right, Linda?
I have to correct you there. Indonesia is not fully secular state.
Well, it's supposed to be.
No. If you look at the Constitution, it never was a fully secular state. There is a room in the Constitution for religion to play into the livelihoods of the people. That's why.
Okay, as opposed to a religious-based government.
Right, we're mixed, we're hybrid. That's what makes it even harder for certain things, because Indonesia does not want to go fully secular or fully religious. We're in the middle.
And that's why, as you said, we have a ministry of religion, right?
In Indonesia, it's always a hybrid. So yeah. they think they can get the best of both worlds.
Yes. And if I may add,
it's not the case.
For inheritance law, for example, for the Muslim Indonesians, it is very clear that only if the parent is the deceased parent is Muslim, then the only children or other heirs, spouses that can get inheritance are the ones that are Muslim. So if the children choose different religions, so for example, in the case of mixed marriages, if the law is not, if the state laws are not completely reformed, then what's going to happen if the deceased parent Muslim cannot leave the inheritance to the non-Muslim heirs, be it spouse or children?
Okay, but when people get married, I don't think they think that far down the road. Yeah, I mean, it's a starting of your life together. Let me ask you both real quickly. Do you think the Constitutional Court review will result in anything, or will just go on? Linda, do you think it'll change?
Down the road, in the long run, perhaps.
About this review this month.
I don't know enough to say. But I don't think so. It will be a long run war, between the elders and the statesmen. It won't happen.
Yeah, it would be nice. It would be shocking. Yeah, but I think it's going to take a little more time. But we need these legal challenges to be brought up to show that there is a groundswell of people. Maybe it doesn't affect a lot of people, but the ones that it does affect, it means a lot. Now, you guys know me. I believe in romance, and challenges make me want something more in some instances, whether the difference are in faith or race or social status. I'd like to believe that love conquers all. Millie, am I naive, Millie?
Yes, in Indonesia, it's more like romancing the stone. The stones will not go. How do they say it? Go unturned?
Yeah, I've dated some stones. Just joking. So what, Millie, you're saying? I shouldn't believe in love and romance and all that stuff?
You should, but just go see more movies. That's my advice.
Go see more movies, yes. Live in a fantasy world, I do. Romance is underappreciated. This Hot Indo special will continue shortly with Daddy Rights. Shouldn't men get time off from work to bond with our newborn?
Saya ingin mengumumkan kerjasama dengan The Indonesia Channel. Saya mendorong semua entitas untuk bergabung dalam upaya ini dengan mempromosikan produk dan layanan mereka di platform digital yang unik ini.
I love Indonesia. I love the food. Yummy.
Ingredients. Now I'm ready to cook. Let's go to the kitchen.
It's done. Let's meet to eat.
Foodiepedia on the Indonesia Channel.
Trần Minh Ngân ở VCCN Net Việt in Hanoi.
I'm Thairat Thomya of Thailand's Thairat TV in Bangkok.
I'm Monica Somborat from the National Television of Cambodia in Phnom Penh.
I'm Raymond Goh of Malaysia's TV Tiga in Kuala Lumpur.
I'm Glenda Chong of Singapore's Channel News Asia.
I'm Sachin Tommy of the Indonesia Channel at the ASEAN Secretariat in Jakarta.
This is your weekly look into the dynamic Southeast Asia region.
ASEAN Today on the Indonesia Channel.
The Best of Bali takes viewers on a special guided tour to the treasures of the Island of the Gods.
Well, the romantic dinner is beautiful.
The Best of Bali, only on the Indonesia Channel.
You're watching a Hot Indonesia special. Okay, after marriage comes, mixed or not, the children. And under Parliament consideration is the updating of parental leave and daddy's rights. Shouldn't fathers get equal benefits as mothers? Lawmakers are considering raising the amount of paid maternity leave for moms from 3 months to 6 months. In the same bill, fathers would also get more time with their newborn from 2 days to 40 days. The bill supporters say the awareness of a dad's role in the earliest stages of a child's life is rising. And I say, right on. I believe that, I know that I love being involved in childcare and tried to be there as much as I could. Linda, if this law is passed, it's a milestone.
Yes, I think because traditionally in Indonesia, child raising has mainly been seen as a main role for the mothers. And I think with the younger generation, you know, the Gen Y and the Gen Z, they start seeing it differently. And I think this would definitely fulfill that gap. So I'm not a mother yet, but I know my friends who have been mothers would have loved to have their husband actually been more involved. And some of the husbands wanted to get more involved, but they just couldn't get anything more than, I believe, 3 day of leave, or the most that I heard was 2 week leave, you know, after the baby was born. And that was like very rare, the 2 week. And 2 week is almost probably nothing, you know, when you're having screaming, pooping babies, you know.
You make it sound like, yeah, anyway, you'll go through it maybe someday. you know, I actually wonder how many men would actually take advantage of it, to be practical. You know, this doesn't affect as many people here as it would in developed countries where, of course, employees have more rights built in and better work packages. But it would be a good statement, Millie. Are you for daddy daycare?
No, I disagree, Dalton. In Indonesia, the custom here is the whole family, the whole shebang takes care of the baby. Not only the mother, the father, also the grandmother, mother-in-law.
Wait, father. You said you don't agree with what? That the extended leave for dads?
No, okay. The current paternity leave is 2 days. And I think that is way too short. Of course, dads gets, you know, they have the rights to also play with the baby and take care of the baby. But having said that, extending it to, let's say, 2 months or 3 months, I think that's a little bit too much. Because, like I said, drawing from personal experience, when I had my baby, really, I had the whole village basically helping me, taking care of this tiny creature. So this is very Indonesian. And our custom here is that, you know, the grandmother, grandfather from both sides, they are too joyful to contribute in not only taking care, but also, you know, things as nitty-gritty as cleaning the baby, bathing the baby, and so on.
Yeah, I think in many countries, including America, grandparents play a very vital role and very, very helpful role, yeah?
Unlike in Indonesia, the grandma, grandpa, they are there like 24 hours for the...
Okay, so really, really involved. Okay, Millie, you touched on something there, and I want to ask Linda, as someone who's been involved in the corporate world and the business world, as you are, of course, Millie, employers might complain that increases in maternity and paternity leaves would hurt their businesses. Linda, how do we argue against that?
It's hard to argue against that because, well, from my corporate career and the few years I work as a headhunter, I knew for a fact that there was already hesitation of employing women of very fertile childbearing age, you know, because they always ask the question, you know, are you planning to get married soon? Are you planning to have more babies and all that? And if there is a candidate, a male candidate or a woman past that age, a woman or a woman that age saying, no, we've got two children and that's enough. And they almost always go with that candidate. So it's hard because you have to remember there are more potential workers than there are jobs in this country. There's supply tops demand. So the power would go with the employer. You know, you can throw any sorts.
No, you mean demand exceeds supply, right? There aren't enough jobs. That's what you're saying, right?
No, supply of workers.
Oh, supply of workers. Okay, I meant a supply of jobs. Okay, go ahead.
Supply
sorry.
Supply of workers exceed the demand. So what I'm trying to say is that you can throw any sorts of very good human right arguments, but you don't really argue against the economics on this, unfortunately. So I'm not saying I'm siding with this. I'm just saying the reality.
Yeah, and that's a problem. It goes back to basic rights of women in the workplace, let alone just maternity or paternity leave. Hiring practices, discrimination, harassment, those are still very real issues for women in this country, which I want to discuss in a future program. The bill says up to 40 days for dads. You know, I doubt that many would take that much time at one time, or maybe I'm wrong. Millie, would you have wanted your husband around more at your childbirth period?
Yeah, for sure. But my husband is a business owner, so he can basically adjust his own timing. But for those who are working in a corporate
schedule,
he did. He took a lot of time to help me with the baby. But for many corporate men, probably they cannot do that for a longer period of time. Yeah.
Without this new law, right? But with the new law, they can.
Yes, they can. But I think it will jeopardize the flow of the work in that company. Because in Indonesian functions, there are so many teammates or, you know, they work in a group, in a small group. They are teams, team member. So I cannot imagine if one team member is away for, let's say, 6 months, you know, for paternity leave or 40
days. Well, no, they, 40 days is only more than a week.
Yeah, but 40 days is a month plus. Yeah, I think it will disrupt the workflow. Whereas actually their presence is not that much needed in a way for 40 days because so many of their family members helping with taking care of the baby.
I say they got to adjust in the workplace. You know, what more important job, and I'm not sure it'd be noble, but than to raising a child and to really bond in the early stages of a child's development. And I believe that. But not sure if it's going to pass, but we will report on it when it does or doesn't. I want to do diapers, really. More of this Hot Indo special is ahead. Sky High Dining. Would you take your date to dinner here?
I'm Caitlin Turner, and welcome to Yoga Bliss. Exhale, reaching down to triangle pose.
Roll your knee out and up to the sky, breathing here.
Yoga Bliss, only on the Indonesia Channel. Indonesia Channel.
You're watching our Hot Indonesia special from Jakarta. Getting that spark in the early stages of romance is important. Some are combining a meal with an adrenaline rush through sky-high dining. It's called Lounge in the Sky, the latest attraction for trend-conscious diners in Jakarta. A crane lifts customers 50 meters above one of the capital's busiest streets for drinks and a meal. Operators say European construction and safety procedures are in place. The cost for each one-hour session runs from 1.6 to 3.7 million rupiah, or $110 to $260. Of course, the first question everyone asks is, can I go to the restroom once I'm up there? And the answer, ladies, is no, so you have to go before you get up in that crane. Millie, you would try this, right? You're the adventurous diner.
Hey, I will try, but come on, at my age, you know, I need that visit to the ladies to the room, you know, and especially after shots or glasses of champagne or wine, you know, I need my toilet break.
Oh, well, you can last 1 hour, Millie. Come on. No, but seriously, would you want to do that? Personally, I think it's too hot and it's too polluted to get in the sky like that.
It's going to be peeing in the sky.
Well, man, rain. But you would try it though, right?
I would. With Linda, yeah. With you, yeah, of course. The three of us.
Hey. What if we did our show from that platform? That would
yes,
be wild.
Yes, I think it would be wonderful. I want to try.
Okay,
I want to try.
Back to the topic, Linda. I would worry about the elements. I mean, I like to eat in air conditioned comfort and not have things flying in my drink. I mean, would you really want to dine there?
Just for the experience, maybe once. But my concern might not be as much of a toilet break, but really the pollution, because, you know, I was born and raised in the city. I know the kind of a pollution I've been inhaling for years. And up there, if you think it's less pollution, it's not necessarily, you know.
Yeah, and it's right above Gatot Subroto, which is one of the busiest.
Thank you.
Yeah, and the carbon monoxide from the cars raises up.
Thank you.
Now, I'm not criticizing this new business because I hope it succeeds. Linda, how much you give it? How many months this will last?
I think about a year, because I bet the operational cost of that place is very high, you know, and then the construction of it. I'm guessing the initial capital outlay will not be cheap, you know? Yeah, I know they're charging quite a lot, but it's tough. Restaurant business is tough. So maybe a year or two, you know? And after everyone has got their try, maybe just once or twice, and they just get bored of it, you know what I mean? It's not like the kind of a diner that you would like to return to every other week, you know, because it's comfortable and all that, you know? People will just go there for experience.
It goes back to the product, though. The food has to be decent, or I'm not going to go at all. I want to hear the reviews, right, Mill? I mean, it comes back.
Probably, comes back. You know, without it, I think, yeah, I know. And the restroom, please, again.
Millie, there's no restroom up there. You gotta empty before you go, if I don't mean to be so crude. It is feedback time, and BN posted this on the YouTube page of our partner, TV1. After our discussion of the huge fee increase to see Komodo dragons since rescinded. I support the best for the survival of Komodo. Here's how to contact us with your feedback. Email at hotindo@theindonesiachannel.com or comment through our Hot Indonesia or Indonesia Channel Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube pages. Final words, Millie.
Okay, so this weekend, I made a decision to stop drinking coffee and start drinking tea instead.
Wow.
But now I'm faced by this challenge of which tea to choose from, because there are black tea, green tea, red tea, yellow tea, white tea. So which one it is? You know, so perhaps some input from the audience will help me indeed.
Final words, Linda.
Indonesia turns 77 this week. It's a big achievement. And I'm sure when we proclaimed independence 77 years ago, a lot of people would assume that we might not make it this far. Yet here we are. So I want to say a happy anniversary to Indonesia. And to our viewers out there, the ones who have been watching us, thank you. I hope you enjoyed the compilation that we showed you. And that for those of you who have not made it to Indonesia, you know, come see this country. It's a beautiful country. It's problematic at times, but it's interesting.
And my final words, you know, high school reunions are fun to some and frightening to others. But whatever changes have occurred, whether it's appearance or achievement, to me, we're all still the same kids who enjoyed prom and inspiring teachers. I'm attending my reunion very soon and look forward to the gray-haired nostalgia. And that is our Hot Indonesia special for this week. For Millie Lukito and Linda Ibrahim, I'm Dalton Tanonaka. Thank you for watching. See you next time.